here. Just a minute. I'm right with you. A minute or two, I'm there. Half an hour at the most. Two hours, I'm sitting. Okay. Thank God there are chairs in the world, huh? Never before have I been so aware of gravity. Now everything is different. Everything is different when you're 95. I'll explain. If right now I am 41, I was diagnosed at the age of 32. Diagnosed with MS. Multiple sclerosis. There was something like more than 9 years ago. So I am 32 plus 9 times 7, which is 63, altogether 95. I am 95 years old. Look pretty good, huh? Here I am polishing. The machine is waking up the whole neighborhood, and I'm thinking to myself, I have MS. Good morning. Ever so precious, I have MS. I read in a book, and the heroine there has it, and it's exactly what I have. I told her right away, you don't have MS. You'll go to the expert next month in Jerusalem, and you'll see all is well. I went. To Professor Odetsky, a world-renowned MS expert. Was sitting like this. That's the brain shell. That's here the left lobe. And these are plaques. Yes, it seems like we're talking about another case of MS here. Professor Odetsky. I'm sitting in his fancy office, with all the beautiful scenery of Jerusalem outside the window, and he's talking to me about the disease. You see, it's MS all right. I knew it. He said exactly what I had known. In Israel, there are 4 or 5 neurologists. All of them are well-renowned. And what good does it do to me? What good does it do to me that they have a global reputation? So, ever since then, I'm trying to get better. That's what I do. Ask me what is your work? I am trying to get out of MS. MS. Normally, it's a relapsing remitting disease. You have all kinds of relapses. All of a sudden, you can't see very well, even go blind. All of a sudden, you're dead tired. Can't get out of bed, but really can't get out of bed. Until it's gone, more or less. That's what most people have. But me? Oh, no, not me. I have progressive MS. My situation is deteriorating constantly without me feeling. I have MS that nobody has. And the progressive kind to boot, which really nobody has. I am among the chosen ones. I am from the MS Commando. I am the elite forces of the MS. Once I was an officer in the Israeli army. After that, I traveled the world, and then I was a stage actor. And finally, I was a computers programmer. Right now, I'm healing from MS. That's what I do. That's my job. That is my job, and to be with the children until ever so precious, ever from now on, that's her name, ever, until ever comes home. When she comes, the struggle begins. To swim or not to swim, that is the question. I have signed an agreement with myself to swim 4 times a week, no matter what, so I know I have to go to the swimming pool. But on the other hand, to sit down and to chat a little bit with Ever, after all day long I've been chatting with myself and then with the kids, but an agreement is an agreement. Sometimes I fall asleep in the parking lot, in the disabled parking lot. Just sit like this. Until everybody laughs, I won't wake up. Sometimes I make my way from the car to the swimming pool, to the showers. Dead tired, a term I've come to know very good in recent years, I sit and stare at the men in the shower, the naked ones. Look at their instruments. But what else could I stare at, huh? Besides their instrument? Get up. They think you're gay and a homophobic will come and kick your ass. And what will you do then? After all, you're sick, weak, miserable. Oh, yeah. After I'm done with the bathing suit ritual and the sandals ritual, here I am getting up and using every last bit of energy, I lean on the wall and make my way to the swimming pool. Foot after foot, 44 steps counted. I make my way, I limp, make my way, go, and I finally make it. I sit to relax, to stare. This time at the feminine instruments, all the instruments. I can sit like this for about an hour, mainly because I don't have the power to move. Stop staring. They think you're trying to hit on someone. And what will you ever be saying? Stop staring because you don't have a chance because you're disabled. At least now I have a good excuse. Before that, I didn't have a good excuse. They always said no. Then I go and spoil it all by saying something stupid like, I love you. Ba-da-ba-da. The song is about me. Swimming, ladies and gentlemen, is boring. Very boring. So I find myself on all kinds of tricks. Open my eyes under the water, meaning when I breathe, my eyes are closed. Caused me a lot of scary accidents. Maybe you'll watch it. The last one was, will you at least look? A young girl, could be my granddaughter. Wait a minute, Madeleine. I have MS, who are you to tell me to stare, to look, or not to look? You're swimming here just to look good. I'm swimming here just so I can go on walking. So I open my eyes under the water. But that's just to keep myself interested. Show some respect, for God's sake. After 20 laps, I get out of the water feeling much better and make my way back home.